Yo guys, it's Bomb Figgy here, and I thought I might change up the intro because I think it would get a little bit boring of me saying the exact same thing. It's kind of funny actually, if you go through my videos and just go from the one to the next, I say the same exact thing every single time. If you guys have any intro that you want me to say that you think would be like really cool or epic, anything like that, make sure to leave it down in the comment section below. I would be really interested in seeing that, but yeah guys, this is my best Black Ops 2 gameplay to date. I go absolute ham in this gameplay. I think the final score is 121-5, so definitely a really great scoreline, and I get a lot of gun kills as well. I kind of rack up to my kill streaks pretty slowly, but once again, my kill streaks as well, those definitely do go to work being at Nuketown and everything. But as you guys know, they actually took out the Nuketown 24/7 playlist, and at first there was no Nuketown at all, which was really unfortunate as it's my favorite map, as you guys know. And I will tell you, I do have some other 100 plus kill games to upload on a map other than Nuketown. It's not like the only map that I can actually get a 100 plus kill game on or anything like that. But like I said, they only have a playlist now. I think it's called like Mosh Pit, where you can barely ever play Nuketown. And honestly, in my opinion, I think you should be able to play it in any playlist. Domination, Free For All, Team Deathmatch, Kill Confirmed, whatever it may be. Because we all went through the trouble of pre-ordering the game, maybe paying a little bit extra for the Nuketown 2025. And I think it should be worth our while. So if you guys could, please leave this video a like. I'm going to actually have hashtag bring back Nuketown 2025 in the title. And basically, every time this video gets a like, it will go onto Twitter. And if we get enough likes, we may be able to even get it trending. And I'm also going to have David Vonderhaar's Twitter linked in there, so it'll tweet him, letting him know about this video. So I would really appreciate it. Let's just see how many likes we can get on this video, guys. That would be absolutely awesome. And you know, I think this is a really good video. It's my best gameplay, so I think it definitely does deserve it. I would really appreciate that, guys. But yeah, man, I definitely do think that Nuketown should be worth the while. And as you guys see, I actually got wallbanged right there, really close to my VTOL warship, which was really unfortunate. I'm not really sure what was up with that. But I definitely do agree when I think that Nuketown 2025 should be in every single playlist. It should just be one that goes through the rotation like every other map. And I don't understand why they would even take out 24/7 Nuketown. A lot of people really did enjoy it, and it was a really good way to rank up, good time to have some fun on the game. I think it was just really good. And when you have something good in the game, I don't understand why you would take it out. Obviously, you could rank up a lot faster if you were playing Nuketown, but the thing is, I'm not really sure why they would care about that. I mean, it's a game, you get a level up faster, and people would enjoy it more. They could go through the prestiges and eventually become the prestige master and have everything unlocked, as you guys know. But anyways, guys, that's pretty much it for that. Just please be sure to leave the video a like. I would really appreciate it. And I'll go over my class setup real quick in this gameplay. It was actually one that was recommended me by TBR Frags, I believe. It was the MSMC. I believe I was using the long barrel, extended clip, and then FMJ, and I'm not really sure if that attachment is actually necessary. From my understanding, at least from now anyways, it only helps when you're trying to shoot people through walls, which obviously I wasn't doing too much in this gameplay. And second, it only helps when you're trying to shoot down killstreaks, it does a little bit more damage. Now, when I was actually getting this gameplay playing right now, it was my understanding that it did more damage on the enemies, which I guess it does not, so I would not recommend using that. I would probably say use something like fast mags or a silencer. I think a silencer is really helpful in this game, actually, because it keeps you off the UAV. If you're running silencer with ghost, you can be really sneaky, get some really nice flank routes. That's what I was doing all day today, just flanking around the enemies and getting a ton of great gameplay. So I would definitely recommend trying something out like that. And then my killstreak loadout, I was using the VTOL warship, attack dogs, or canine unit in this gameplay. And then the swarm, which is basically the kill horse setup that gets you a boatload of kills. So I would really recommend that setup to you guys. And then my perks, I was using flak jacket and hardline. Now, recently I've been using flak jacket and ghost, and obviously you have to use the perk 1 wildcard or whatever, which definitely does help out a lot. And then for my perk 2, I'm pretty sure I was using scavenger. And one thing I would recommend, guys, instead of using 3 attachments like I was in this gameplay, only use 2 attachments, so that way you don't have to use the extra wild card, and throw on C4 along with scavenger. You can get so many great kills with C4 or bouncing betties. Those definitely do help out a lot, and it's just something really convenient. You can just chuck it at an enemy if they're not accessible, and I would really recommend trying that out. Make sure to double tap X also if you don't know that trick about the C4s or whatever. But yeah, one last thing that I wanted to mention before this video comes to an end. I'm actually going to be hosting a commentator challenge, and this is going to be similar to the one that I was in with Green Goblin HD. I'm not really sure if you guys caught that one, because that was definitely a really long time ago. I think I was about 4,000 subscribers when that went down and everything. It was right after I got that Moab against the Mark of J, but I want to host one of these myself to help out some of my subscribers. And basically how it's going to work, I'm going to choose 10 people to be in this commentator challenge, and they're gonna have to upload a video of my own to their channel. Just basically, it's me explaining the rules of the competition and letting their subscribers know how it's gonna work and everything, and it's gonna be voted by the comments. So all of my subscribers and all of their subscribers, if they choose to upload a video saying to vote for them, will be voting for the commentators, deciding which one's gonna win. It's not gonna be biased at all. Obviously, if there's a bigger channel with more subscribers, they can upload a video to their channel saying to vote for them. But they're also going to have my viewers as well, so you guys will have to vote for the winners of each commentator showdown. And it's going to be single elimination. I thought it would be something really cool just to give back to you guys. And I'm going to get some really good commentators as well as gameplay. It's going to be a commentary gameplay mix. It's not exactly a commentator showdowns, because I'm going to be looking at the gameplay as well, and I'm sure you guys will be too. So I just want to give you guys a little heads up on that. And if there's anyone that you think should be entered in this commentator challenge, make sure to leave them down in the comment section below. I'll be sure to check them out. And the size of their channel, it really does not matter. All I'm looking for is just quality videos that I think anyone would enjoy. So yeah guys, that's pretty much it. My best gameplay to date. I would really appreciate it if you guys could leave a like on this video, and also subscribe if you're new to the channel. But that's pretty much it guys. Peace out.